Thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It is common practice that contracts with doctors in hospitals are terminated automatically when the doctor reaches the age of 65, so at retirement age. This automatic character of the ending is made possible by a contractual clause which reads as follows. The contract of indefinite duration between the hospitals and a physician will be automatically terminated at the end of the month the physician reaches the age of 65. So we certainly have an age-based difference of treatment here. If you're under 65, you can continue to work. If you're above 65, you have to quit. So is this difference of treatment, is it unlawful? And if so, can we use the increasing quality risks of an aging doctor as lawful justification for termination at 65? So in Belgium, but also in most other European countries, hospital physicians can have different social statuses. They can work and be active in the hospital as an independent, or as employees, or as civil servants on a statutory basis. But notwithstanding these completely different social statuses, their legal relationship with the hospital ends at retirement age, at 65. So there are, of course, very specific rules on employees in the Employees Act. We will not go into the details of these acts. But oddly enough, the termination of the contract for the employees and of the civil servants possess no legal problem. That is the case, though, for the independent doctors, and they represent 85% of the hospital physicians. The main reason why the difference of treatment can be an unlawful discrimination lies, of course, in the discrimination laws, ANTIs. First of all, there is the European directive establishing the general framework for equal treatment. Differences of treatment based on age are non-discriminatory when, and it's there, a characteristic constitutes a genuine and determining occupational requirement, provided that the objective is legitimate and the requirement is proportionate. Differences of treatment are also non-discriminatory if it can be objectively and reasonably justified by a legitimate aim, and if the means of achieving that aim are appropriate and necessary. These two exceptions, or maybe better, justifications, are transposed into the laws of the member states, and in Belgium that happened in 2007. Now, let's have a look at the case law of the European Court of Justice on these two justifications. First of all, the genuine and determining occupational requirements. Secondly, the legitimate aims. First of all, what is a genuine and determining occupational requirement? What is it? Well, it can, for instance, involve the physical condition for certain occupations, like requirements for dancers or child actors. If you're 80 years old, you can't claim to play Mowgli in Jungle Book. That's for clear. So the European Court did the genuine and determining occupational requirement test in 2010 for a fireman. The city of Frankfurt had refused an application for a career post as a fireman in the fire brigade because the applicant had exceeded the age of 30. It was an age limit. Above 30, no fireman. The court accepted the argument of Frankfurt that a fireman needs to possess full physical capacity and that this capacity is related to age. The European Court ruled that the concern to ensure, and I quote, the operational capacity and proper functioning of the professional fire service constitutes a legitimate objective. The European Court ruled otherwise a year later, in 2011, on the Lufthansa case. Lufthansa argued that an automatic termination of a contract of their pilots at the age of 60 is lawful with the aim of guaranteeing air traffic safety. Lufthansa put it forward, that is, and I quote again, it is essential that airline pilots possess particular physical capabilities insofar as physical defects in their profession may have significant consequences and undeniable that those capabilities diminish with age. The court didn't agree. It is not a proportionate measure that is necessary for public security and protection of health, because national and international laws provide that pilots may continue to carry out the activities under certain physical conditions, of course. Now, it would be interesting to know if the European Court would consider age cutoffs for physicians applying for emergency doctors, driving ambulances, or heavy night services as a genuine determining occupational requirement. Are these doctors to be compared with pilots, or are they to be compared with firemen? Do they have to possess full physical capacities? If so, age cutoffs for doctors are lawful. The case law of the European Court of Justice on the second justification, so the legitimate aim, is more generic and far less factual. An age difference is objectively and reasonably justified by a legitimate aim if the means of achieving that aim are appropriate and necessary. So legitimate aims and the possible justifications are non-exhaustive. Legitimate is for example, aims at the distribution of employment opportunities among the generations. That's one. Legitimate is, for example, the allocation of posts between the generations. And legitimate is, again, the balanced age structures. So no inverted age pyramid in hospitals in these service, meaning giving sufficient access to employment by younger people. So, in fact, there is a broad margin of appreciation. And a very interesting, possible, legitimate aim is the quality of care. In other words, can quality or the absence of quality be a justification for an age-based difference of treatment? The European Court again ruled that the retirement of dentists at 68 is an inconsistent measure because it didn't apply to all dentists. Okay. Not, for instance, for those practicing outside the statutory health insurance scheme. In the Gorgiev case, a forced retirement of professors at 68 was justified because the quality of teaching and the best possible allocation of posts between generations can be a legitimate aim. So sometimes an abstract age limit, a more generic one, a collective sort of ruling, is accepted to prevent an individual assessment. The joint courts of Hall of Islands, Aruba, Curaçao, St. Martin, Bonaire, St. Eustatius, and Saba, it's a joint court, ruled in 2011 on a gynecologist. A 76-year-old gynecologist was laid off by the hospital because he got too old to do the job properly. The joint court ruled that a maximum age of 65 for a medical specialist is reasonable. So I quote, "It is a general rule of experience that when a higher age is reached, the probability of inferior psychologically and physical health increases. The use of an objective age limit can be implemented indiscriminately and is preferable to a system whereby on a case-by-case basis has to be examined if the older specialist is still proficient in fulfilling his work adequately." So, especially in the field of healthcare, the risks of malfunctioning must be kept as small as reasonably possible. According to the court, reaching the age of 65 is sufficiently compelling and also a reasonable ground to terminate the agreement with the medical specialist. But anyway, the burden of proof is whether it is a legitimate aim always lies on the hospital. The Belgian courts followed the reasoning of the European Court of Justice. I'm not going into the details of these decisions, but they confirmed the principle that an age-based difference of treatment is only justified when it has a legitimate goal and is done by, of course, these proportionate means. Now, we more or less know how the courts will deal with age-based differences of treatment. We have to take a look at the implications for hospital practice. The starting point always is the prohibition of all age-based distinctions. Age limits are exceptionally justified and non-discriminatory if a legitimate aim is invoked and accepted. So, of course, the justification can be included in individual contracts or in collective agreements, but merely invoking a legitimate aim is not enough. It's never enough. A concrete assessment is always necessary. So a legitimate aim in one case can be illegitimate in another. And an age limit is always conditional and non-automatic. The invoked goals have to be weighed against each other. Mediocre or low quality because the older physician isn't retrained properly has to be balanced against, for example, the fact that this medical discipline is scarce. So You can choose to settle for lower quality and let the physician work further, but you can't use the argument that you have to make place for younger doctors if there are no younger doctors available. Ladies and gentlemen, I come to my short conclusion. Already, fine, good in time. Automatic terminations of contracts when reaching the retirement age are still very, very widespread in hospitals, not only in Belgium. Due to this European anti-discrimination legislation, this is not allowed anymore and is qualified as discriminatory. Age-based distinctions can, however, be justified. We saw that. Different approaches and justifications are possible using different criteria, often with the same result. Before making a distinction based on age, a thorough assessment is needed. But automatic terminations, however, are always unlawful. Thank you.